set up the cable or the band so that the handle or the band handle, whatever you're using, is in line with your lower ribs, okay? So can you see my elbow is in kind of in line with my forearm here? Then from there, you're going to split your stance. So I've got the opposite leg to the arm that's going to go forward. So I've got my right arm in the cable or the band and my left leg forward. From here, we're really going to focus on, as we're pressing forward, that we're using our chest muscle. I like to alternate my hands here. I find this quite like a powerful stance. So I try and drive one arm forward as I drive the other arm back. But you can, if you want to, just place your hand on your chest to kind of remind you to really press through the chest. Now, what we don't want to do is over-rotate. So don't let the cable or the band pull you backwards. We're trying to keep our hips and our shoulders square, okay? So really focusing on that core connection to do so. Now, we also want to make sure that we're stacking our ribs and our pelvis in line together, but we don't want to crunch, okay? We don't want that kind of gripping sensation. So as best as you can, try to keep your ribs stacked over your pelvis. Inhale as you draw the cable or the band back. Exhale as you press forward. Again, this is a really powerful movement, so really think about making it explosive and powerful. With a band, make sure that you pop your hand through the handle like so. Whether you're using a loop band or a handle band, you want the band running through the middle of your palm. Then from there, you may notice that the band doesn't have as much tension like as it pulls you back, but you might have lots of tension as you press forward. So don't worry if you kind of have to readjust a couple of times. Really press through. Make sure this is challenging you. And then once you've done so many on one arm, I want you to switch onto the other arm.